Hello guys, I'm Joshua8600. Welcome to Kingdom Hearts Re-Chain of Memories. Let's try blind. Oh, there's a cutscene. So yeah, I finished Kingdom Hearts 1 a couple of days ago. And I remember that, the stained glass. Whatever. I don't want to watch that cutscene. It might be the start. It might be happen when I start the game anyway. So without further ado, new game. Standard mode. Difficulty is well balanced. Let's see, easy mode, recommend for, yeah, I'm not inexperienced, so I'm just going to do standard. Vibration, turn that on. Stereo audio, I don't know what any of this means. I'll just do stereo. Please confirm your settings. Okay. I don't remember having to do all that when I did Kingdom Hearts 1. Okay, but we're playing Chain of Memories. I'm not going to keep saying re-Chain of Memories, no, it's Chain of Memories. And here's the cutscene. So, I'm going to turn up the volume on the TV a little bit so I can hear the song that plays. Okay. So, I finished Kingdom Hearts 1 in about 29 hours, I think. Yeah, like I didn't get an exact number, but I'm pretty sure it was like 29 hours. Definitely under 30, but somewhere around that. So there's Leon right there. This is just a recap of like pretty much the entire first game. Never, what's that called? There, that was a Colosseum. First one's Wonderland. 100 Acre Wood. I was trying to say Neverland, but I knew that wasn't right. Wonderland. There, that's Neverland right there. Tinkerbell actually heals you, I learned. Agrabah. Monstro, Riku's heel turn right there, Atlantica, Halloween Town. I actually like Halloween Town as a world. I just hated the boss, seriously. Oogie Boogie, first form was terrible. This was, that battle against Riku was very, very difficult. This one right here specifically. Anything else to say while the... No, and then, Kairi, brought Sora back somehow. According to the Jiminy Cricket's journal, it just said their strong bond awakened a light within Sora, so that brought him back or something like that. I don't know. The final fight with Ansem. It's a shame you can't save after you beat him. Yes, they close the door. Riku helps King Mickey close the door. Right there. Because he has an awesome keyblade, King Mickey. So, but the door gets closed. And then Mickey's like, if there's heart or something, there'll always be a door to the light or something. So this I don't understand. Shouldn't they just be put back into the world they came from? Well, then again, Kairi didn't technically come from Destiny Islands, did she? So, who knows? But I remember what happened at the end in the cutscene. Sora, Donald, and Goofy find Pluto right here, basically. They have a letter with the King Mickey seal on it. Like, come on, let's go. And then they run after Pluto, and that's the end of the game. That was the end of Kingdom Hearts 1. I'm not sure if there was more after it in the final mix. I don't know, because I only have the first one, and I didn't look anything up. Which I probably should have looked up anything final mix or extra stuff. I just realized I never read through the Ansem's reports, so I'm probably missing a little bit of backstory, but I can always read through those later. I'm going to turn down the volume now, it's loud. Just that song was quiet for some reason. So they're on this long trek. Fork in the road. The road ahead lies something you need. Okay. Who is that?
However, in order to claim it, you must lose something that is dear to you.
Okay, to get something that I need, I must lose something that is dear to me. Okay. That's like a birdcage, kind of. Don't know what that drawing is supposed to be. It's supposed to be that. This looks like the castle, or looks like something that belonged in the end of the world. I don't remember entering a place like that. No, I think I do, actually. The end of the world when you, re-chain a memory. Kingdom Hearts re-chain a memory. Is that a thing you did in the end of the world? Did you enter a castle? I remember I entered a portal. I don't think I entered a castle specifically, so I think this is a new place. When Sora gasped, kind of, it sounded deeper than it was in Kingdom Hearts. I'll just say the first game. Do I get to play it? Like, how did they get here to this place? Weren't they just on this road? Speaking of which, where did Pluto go? They were chasing after him. Where did Pluto go? It's another question I have.
Hey, you think it's okay to barge in?
But we gotta do it,
after the king. The king? King Mickey's here?
I don't know, is he?
Something just told me he'd be here, okay?
Is this his castle?
Really? Cause now that you mention it, I was kinda thinking the same thing.
Seriously? Me too. One look at this castle, and I just knew.
Yeah, that's definitely
our very best friends. They're here.
Guess great minds think alike.
Wait, hey, hold on. It can't be just a coincidence.
Oh no, Timothy. You don't mean that.
I don't really talk a lot during
concerts. I had it too. Mm-hmm. I had the exact same feeling.
Gorge, maybe it's contagious.
No, something screwy. We gotta go.
Is that, he says screwy? Because that looks like Sarui on the text. Whack.
That way, to the door. Are you scared?
After playing, you know, the first game for 28, 29 hours, that voice is not,
Shouldn't we shut the door behind
us? Sounds odd.
Here we go. Sora!
Oh, well, hey, it's that guy who told us to find what we need. We must do something dear to us.
That's it. Who are you?
And he could just summon the Keyblade. I didn't know that. There's nothing.
Come on. Thunder. Thunder.
Cool.
Come on. Blizzard. Fire.
Good try, Donald.
Why isn't it working?
I should think it's obvious. The moment you set foot in this castle, you forgot every spell and every ability you ever knew.
What?
In this place, to find is to lose, and to lose is to find. That is the way in Castle Oblivion.
Castle Oblivion.
Castle Oblivion?
Now, I know a little bit about this game. Of course, it's called Chain of Memories. It has something to do with memories.
The past. And you will meet people you miss.
I miss? Riku! You mean Riku's here?
If what you want is to find him.
Okay. Yeah, he just. That's kind of weird.
What'd you do?
I need to keep commentating. I don't know what to say.
I merely
right now.
Sampled your memories.
Sampled
and
your
from
memories.
Them, I made this.
What is that?
To reunite with those you hold dear.
What's this? A card?
Some kind
it
of
is
card.
A promise for the reunion you seek.
moments.
Hold the car to open the door, and beyond it a new world.
So I have to go through the worlds from the first game.
To lose and claim anew, or to claim anew only to lose.
So I have to lose. So if I want to learn more, I have to forget what I currently know. And to get any memories back, I have to lose.
Come on.
I have to.
Let's go.
Whatever. Figure it out. Card obtained, Traverstown. So I know this was originally a Game Boy Advance game, Chain of Memories. That's all I know about. Select world. Select card. Left analysis, select card. You only have one at this point. That's just notification. X confirm. Okay. Trevor's down. Door wide open. I was trying to think of some reference I can make from Star Trek The Next Generation episode Darmok, but I couldn't remember any of the lines specifically, except Darmok and Jalata Tanagra. This can't be right. We're in Traverse Town. What you see isn't real. So this is just a memory world? Kind of? This town is an illusion created by your memories ingrained in that card. My memories? Forget about that, Sora. We lost all the Goofy. Donald, Goofy, guys, where are you? What'd you do with them? Let's see the cards. Now, the heart of the cards? Hey, this game, the Kingdom Hearts is all about heart, so believe in the heart of the cards. Master the cards, and their strength will be yours again. There we go. Worked in the perfect Yu-Gi-Oh! Reference. I'm starting off this Let's Try pretty good. Okay, the laws of this castle require that your friends be transformed into cards. If you value your friends, you won't fail to pick them up. Okay, now I have a friend card. Is this turn-based? Cards you pick up are added to the top of your stack. Use them and your friends will come to your aid. X, use cards. Cards you use vanish, but they will reappear to aid you time and again. Cards are the hearts of your friends, okay? Everything in this castle is ruled by cards. Whether an enemy or a door confronts you, cards are the only way to proceed. You mustn't forget your own strength. Okay, I can jump and dodge roll just like in the first game. First think of yourself. First think for yourself. Move, then use the cards. You now know how to use your strength, but it would be of no use if you decide your opponent. I wonder if you can catch me. That's a different button for targeting than in the first game. I'm pretty sure it was R1 before. That's what I instinctually went to without having about it. Now it's R2. That could be me forgetting, but I'm pretty sure it was R1. Every move you make causes a card to disappear. If you use up all your cards, you'll be unable to act. There's a solution. Keep using cards until you run out, and I will show you. So I'm almost out of cards, and I don't know. Okay, this is kind of interesting. You have no more cards, and without them, no power. If you want that power back, you must focus. Then the cards return to you, and they will. Reloading cards. D-pad up, quickly select reload card. Hold X, reload card. Okay. Can I select? The strength of your heart brought back the lost cards. You can recall spent cards at any time you only need wish each time you do, the cards will take longer to return. Cards are by no means unlimited, use them wisely. Anticipate the flow of battle. And choose the most effective cards. You may use any card in your deck. L1 cycle. Oh, okay. You can't use the D-pad. Oh, you can use the D-pad for that. But it works in reverse. I press D-pad right and it moves to the left.
Jeez.
The four card types you use in battle are grouped into two wider categories. The first category includes attack cards, magic cards, and item cards. The second category consists entirely of enemy cards. To use cards from a different category, select button. Select button. Change categories. Interesting. Okay, how do I use it? Oh, you just wanted me to change back. Never mind. Cards will empower you whether you are attacking or defending. But it's up to you to decide when to attack and when to defend. Do not forget that. I assume I'll get good at the game over time. This seems very confusing. I wonder how it's like on Game Boy Advance, how they did this. Kind of curious. Are you two all right? Where have you been? Tell us. You opened the door, we saw a strange light. It's just blank. There were cards. What's Jiminy doing? Gee, that doesn't help. Will his journal be of any use in terms of memories? Gee, that doesn't help. I know that has something to do with, like, recoded his journal or something, but I'm not going to get into that game right now. Gee, that doesn't help. I'm trying to remember what happened. I have to keep my journal up to date. Hey, Donald. Get the new clothes. What? So do they not remember what they were dressed as? I'm so confused. That's for you to ponder. Master the cards and make your way through the castle. And from here you walk alone. Alone? You can't let Sora go alone.
Yeah, Sora can't do either without our help.
It's a lot, Donald. I'm sure you'll be okay, of course. I don't know. Well, actually, if I'm doing just cards, I don't have all these spells. You might want me to go alone? Fine, I can take care of myself.
The hero speaks boldly. Go, then. The rest of the council oblivion awaits.
Walk the avenues of light and memory, and you shall meet someone new. Riku! Right? Got a bad feeling about this. Relax, Jiminy. Ready for any tricks. Got up his sleeve. We need to figure out these cards. Is use one in front of that door over there. Card obtained, key of beginning. So that's just great. So is the game auto-saving for one? Or is that a loading symbol? Oh, I missed this. Traverse Town. I love Traverse Town in the first game. You can perform the following actions in the field. Move, look around with the right analog. R3? What the heck is an R3? X, swing, keyblade, jump, dodge roll, yeah, we know that. Striking objects. Try striking the barrel. I couldn't lock onto it. Oh, did I get a card? Blizzard. Music sounds enhanced, like I don't think it had this bass before. Mark, I was just gonna be lifted and thrown. At least I didn't hear it before, but my TV I think is a little louder unless I turn it back down. I can't remember. It was a Heartless. Touching a Heartless, the field starts a battle. So you can strike the Heartless first to gain the upper hand. Okay, so it kind of is turn-based. Not turn-based, but... Okay, I do like this camera. Better than the first game. Although, I think the first game's camera does not exist at all. What did I just do? Card obtained, Tranquil Darkness. I keep pressing R2 trying to cheat the camera, and that's the lock-on button. R1 just cycles, and that used to be the lock-on button. That's going to take some time to get used to. To open doors in the field, press triangle in front of the door. I still want to know what R3 is. Okay, can I change these camera settings? They're reversed. And if I'm using the right stick, I definitely need them to be the way I play any other game with the camera. Like, I could have handled it with buttons in the first game. No, I absolutely need it. I wonder if I can... I can't pause yet, so... Maybe if I get through the tutorial, I'll have to pause. To proceed to the next room, you need a map card. Map cards are used to synthesize new, unexplored rooms. First, select the map card you want to use. Is this a map? This isn't a map card. This is the key of beginnings, perhaps? Is this... How do I know if it's a map card? Is that what, yellow is? I'll just choose the key. No. What's this? A room where I can save your progress. Okay, I guess blue is a map card, because I can read the things below. So I can form a room where only a few heartless appear, but this one's... Okay, I understand now. Two of them are grayed out. I didn't notice that until now. Room where untold stories unfold. Save your progress, no heartless. The number you see in the middle of the screen is the criterion for opening the door. One. Criterion display now means that the door will open with the value of 1 or greater. You need to pick a card that meets this criteria. Cards of 1 from 0 to 9, 0 cards, and special cards which meet all criteria. Okay. Card without a marked value is a key card. Without a marked value is a key card. Key cards only use at special doors. I heard, just like, when I was asking a general question, to people about Kingdom Hearts, they said that the first game is pretty much the only game that's like really non-linear. So maybe this is gonna be a really linear game, so it'll make more sense if I keep playing. The swirling crystal in front of you is called Safe Point. Good. Triangle this time. Ooh, that jump. The camera follows you with it. Okay, save menu. Slot 1. You can save to new file. I've already been playing for 21 minutes. Wow, I have. Moments reprieve. Okay. Now what do I do? Can I pause now? I can. Settings. Please tell me. Camera. Reverse. Thank goodness. Camera vertical. What's that like? No, I want that. This is perfect now. Ooh, that void over there. I guess it's all just because my memory doesn't go on beyond that far. But no, now this camera actually works, so I like that. Okay, Kingdom Key. Right now I'm just gonna open these boxes. I don't know what all these other things are. There's a door I came from. Can't go out there. And I just pressed L2 trying to change the camera. Oh, these I can destroy too. What is this red symbol? Total magical? I don't know what that's saying. Okay, let's look at the journal first. Story. Okay, none of that. Hold on a second. Okay, I am back. So, again, I was looking at the journal. Card collection, what's this? I don't know. Card index. So this could be useful, I guess. Kingdom keys, that's an attack card. Friend cards. Characters, just a list of all the characters so far. Sora, Donald, Goofy, Jimmy, Pluto. Okay. Oh wait, there's more down there. The Heartless. So far, just a shadow. Okay. Status. What is this? Bizarra, Bizagra, Kira, Kiraga. Magic level 2. Donald. I don't know any of this so far, obviously. world map. This room where you can save your progress, no heartless. So all these are rooms in the specific world. Huh. How bizarre. That's all I'm gonna say about this so far. It's just bizarre. Oh, and it's like Link where he, every time he moves, he sounds. Hey, let's move on to the next room. Number two or higher or zero. How do I know? I can use either of these. Oh, I see in the bottom, card information. There we go. Like, I was looking for it on the screen. Like, you would think that the number would be bigger. Okay. Oh, kinda District 3. Not really. That I just... Oh. What happens if I just try going up here and skip the heartless? Like, there's a room right there. Okay. Let's, I can't lock on. I can't lock on, in the world. Wait, what did I just do? I just want to, oh, I did level up, I guess. I have to hold that. I don't understand what I'm doing at all. Yeah, I'm very confused right now. Like, I'm just pressing buttons. I just want to swing my keyblade. I need these cards. Here, can I use Donald? At least, those kind of cards don't immediately, what's it called? Card obtained, meaning ground. Let's, level up so I can choose a bonus. What is CP? Learn a new slate. I don't know what that means either. Sliding dash. I think right now I'm just gonna do an HP boost because I'm probably gonna take damage. A lot of damage as I'm trying to figure out how to play the game. I didn't even see that right now. Like, I just wanna be able to sweep my keyblade and combo with that. Alright, just heal. Oh. Where all these things that I'm using? I don't think these are. I think these cards are just part of when you battle. Like, because they come back. They're not cards. They're not like one-time use, like items. I guess. But I really don't know. No, I don't know. Here, what happens if I hit select? I have nothing. Okay. Lock on to you. I did not want to use it. At least you don't also, when you have to hold the button, at least you don't have to do it without getting hit. Feeble darkness, next level. This time I'll do CP. I don't know what that is. It'll probably be important. So I can go in this door. Hey, look. Yeah, District 3. Except it's not really the 3. I need a card with 3 or higher. This is a 3. The room are heartless with weak cards appear. If you have friends, a friend card appears at the start of battles. Room are untold stories unfold. I don't want to use that. Like, do I have to go through or can I just open? I have to go through. No, I can't go back though. So that's because I want to go back. So if I go to my world map, yeah, it says, what are these cards that are showing on the map now? So I entered here, but there's, no, I'm right here. I did enter here. Oh, so it showed I had to use a 2 card to go through there, and that's all just showing whatever. Did it? Why is there a 4 on the map? But I know I can also go this way. And is there a door over here too? There we go. At least I got a first strike. Oh, is that it? I guess that was the whole battle. Got a card. Kingdom Key. I'm so confused about what's happening right now. I don't want to use my support items. Like, I feel like support should be its own category, or shouldn't auto-select support cards when you just want to attack, you know? Premium room. Whatever that is. Is this a spring? It is. That's kind of funny. I don't know how that can be in Sora's memories, because I don't remember one of those things ever being in the prison. Look at the Sora spring. Whatever. What's card three? Maybe there's some kind of setting I don't know. So I think I just get things when I kill them all, they all just come to me, the items do. So that's good. I'm gonna go in the previous room because I wanna save. So let's do that. Slot 1. Overwrite. 0 MP. So do you still get magic and everything too? So everything's done with the cards. You just have to leave.